Do what she loves to do with the greatest of love. She is healthy, whole, and
so good morning, good morning. Welcome to Unity Center in Milwaukee. We're very pleased that you're with us today to share in the oneness of the divine life within. Today is a beautiful day, sunshine and cool. And we ask that we slowly start centering into the peace that is within us, into hearing the word, into being with one another this day. My name is Sue Nevela. I am the chaplain for today. I will be by the dove after service if anyone has prayers that they want to do after all of our prayers that we share in this moment. Today's daily word is world peace. Affirming the divinity of all the world's people, I envision world peace. Peace is meant for every person of every faith in every land. Today I look beyond the news of the world, reports of strife and conflict, even the agitation and unforgiveness in my own heart, and we find the peace of God. I believe the desire for lasting peace is within each person's heart. In prayer, I affirm this truth and envision this desire growing stronger among the world's people until peace can no longer be denied. It is our shared destiny to live in peace when each person wants for all people what they want for themselves. Harmony will blanket the earth. I affirm the peace I wish for myself is dawning in the hearts of others. In prayer, I see them safe and secure in the heart of God, forever at peace. From Thessalonians, the second book, 3:16, now may the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in all ways. And now I invite you all to stand and join the musicians for our opening song.
Let us gather together. This is a place of love. Welcome together as people of prayer. This is a house built on love. Come, let us gather in peace. This is a sacred space. We join our hearts here in one loving camp. This is a house built on love. We come together as people of prayer. This is a house built on love.
Thank you, everybody. Please be seated. Wow. I'm so happy to see all of you. Welcome, everybody, and everybody in media land. The weather is beautiful here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. It's nice and cool. No rain. The sun is shining. We like the light. That's what this church is all about, the light. So I'm glad you're all here. And don't any of you ever hesitate to reach out to me if you have any questions or concerns or prayer needs that you would like me to work with you on. Don't hesitate to call, send an email, something, a smoke signal, I'll try to read it. If I can't, you know, I'll get help. So anyways, I would like for all of us to affirm together what we believe in here at Unity. And number one, there is only one presence and one power in the universe and in our lives, and God the good. Number two, our essence is of God, therefore we are inherently good. This God essence was fully expressed in Jesus the Christ. Number three, we are co-creators with God, creating reality through thoughts held in mind. Number four, through prayer and meditation, we align our heart mind with God. Number five, through thoughts, words, and actions, we live the truth we know. Amen. All right. And let's do our church affirmation. We are here to love and build our personal relationship with God, to love God with all our mind, heart, and soul, and to love our neighbors as ourselves. Some days that's easier than others, right? But we keep working on it. All right, now it's time for our prayer request, and I'm going to put Glenda at the top of the list and Mark. She's back in the emergency room, so we need to send a lot of prayers for her perfect healing, that her body is restored to health and wholeness again as God created it. And also for the church growth and its resources to nicely provide for this establishment called God's House. And now, who else has request? Yes. Oh, nice. What's your mom's name again? I forgot, Dave. Donna. Safe travels. All right, who else? Yes. Sherry. Okay. Yes. Okay, for healing. Everything's about healing, isn't it? Yes. Rhoda. I love that. Remember Mary Tyler Moore, her best friend, Rhoda? Wasn't she hysterical? I love that woman. I'm like, Rhoda, okay. Yes. Who else? Somebody, I saw somebody else. Yes. Terry and Marge. Okay. Who else? Yes. Jen and Joe. Okay. Yes.
Bob and Alice.
Bob and Alice.
Okay. For Joe, for healing, for his voice and for his memory.
Okay. Healing, healing, healing. Yes, Joanne. Oh, I'm so sorry. What's your sister's name? Rosalie. Okay. Anybody else? Yes. Raise vibration on what? Oh, togetherness. And for our foreign wars that are going on, world peace. Yes, Beth. Oh, birthday wishes. Health, happiness, and wealth. Oh, yeah, all the above. And for his sister, too, yeah. Especially Beth. Yeah, because I know he's got another sister. We can bless her too, but yeah. Anybody else? Yes. 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 Wow. Happy birthday, Andrew. Okay. Anybody else? Yes, Diane. Jack. Peace. Are we all seeking peace? More peace in our lives? Okay. Anybody else? I'm going to put Sierra and her mom. They're safe travels back from California, from their jobs. Okay. All right. So let us pray. Infinite Spirit of love, life, and wisdom, we ask that you bestow your blessings and your healing and your wholeness back to everyone on this list, everyone in this congregation, plus their family members. There is only one true power and presence in this world, and it is you, God. May it emanate from each and every one of us in a very special way, increasing the vibration of this world because we need it. And so it is. Amen. We have meditation music, and then we will move into our meditation. Feel the vibration of the music. Music is very healing and restoring to the body and also to the mind. To the mind, it really rejuvenates the mind.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us, only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no country. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. No religion to. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will be as one. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. The brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people sharing all the work. You may say I'm a dreamer, but you're not the only one. Hope someday you will join us, and the world will live as one. I hope someday you will join us, and the world will live as one.
Here in this room and in the midst of you, I call in all of God's angels to be here with us. And I ask these angels to minister to us in the ways that each of us need to be ministered to. So let's breathe in the breath of God and exhale out anything that is not of God. Breathe in again the light and love of God. And just exhale out all the to-do list and the journey for the rest of your day. And be still and know that God is in the midst of you. Let my words be your words as we pray. Take this into your mind and then into your heart. I am the peace of God. I am the peace of God that passes all understanding. I live, I move, and have my being in this peace. I am the love of God. I am the love of God that is pure and unconditional. I call forth this peace and this love to emanate through me. Blessing everyone that I come in contact with. May my energy only be of God and nothing else. We ask you, God, help us to love ourselves. We ask you, dear God, to help us forgive ourselves, so that we may forgive others. Let us be still and sit in the silence as we feel the silence become us.
In the stillness, we find the peace of God. I am peace. I am peaceful. I bring peace to the world. I am the love of God, and I find this love in the stillness. This pure, unconditional love. I love myself. I love myself. I love others. Even though I may not understand them or what they do, I am loving them, for I am love in motion. We ask you, dear God, to remove from our mind any negative thoughts. We ask that you remove from our hearts any negative emotions or feelings that we may have that hold back your love from flowing through us. We affirm and we believe that we are love. Gently say, I am love. I am love that God is. I am the love that God is. We give you thanks, dear God, for our oneness with you. Increase our awareness of our oneness with you through our thoughts, our words, and our actions, so that we dissolve separation and only know oneness. We praise you for this time together in the Christ consciousness. And we move forward through this day in a greater awareness of who we are as spiritual beings. And so it is. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Susan, Kevin, Linda, Beth, and David back there on the soundboard. We really appreciate your time and your talents that you give so freely to this church and to your friends here, your fellow congregants. So today, we're going to talk about the story of Ruth and Naomi. And I want to tell you, it's a very short book in the Bible. It's only four chapters. But the more I read about this story and got into it and got into the metaphysics of it, it is such a powerful story. You know, the whole purpose of this story being put in the Bible was about how three people stayed strong when society was falling apart. And I just would like you to read part of this story so that you understand about what I'm talking about. And
This is the most famous chapter, chapter one, when Naomi and Ruth return to Bethlehem. And Naomi, her husband died, and then her two sons died, okay? And so her two daughter-in-laws were still with her. They were very devoted to her. So when I just want to make sure I'm starting in the right place. When Naomi heard in Moab that the Lord had come to the aid of his people by providing food for them, she and her daughter-in-laws prepared to return home from there. Where her two daughter-in-laws, she left the place where she had been living and set out on the road that would take them back to the land of Judah. Then Naomi said to her two daughter-in-laws, now, listen to the devotion here of the daughter-in-laws and of Naomi. She says, go back, each of you, to your mother's home. She wanted them to stay there. May the Lord show you kindness. She's blessing them, as you have shown kindness to your dead husbands and to me. May the Lord grant that each of you will find rest in the home of another husband. And she's wishing them love and that they find happiness again. What a beautiful gift. What a beautiful blessing that she is bestowing upon her daughter-in-laws. Then she kissed them goodbye and they wept aloud. And she said to her, we will go back with you to your people. Her daughter-in-laws are saying, we want to go with you. We really want to go with you. Now, usually people have issues with their mother-in-laws, right? Well, obviously, these two women didn't. They really honored her. They really respected her because of her wisdom and her relationship with God. So it goes back. But Naomi said, return home, my daughters. Why would you come with me? Am I going to have any more sons who would become your husbands? Rehome, my daughters. I am too old to have another husband. Even if I thought there was still hope for me, even if I had a husband tonight and then gave birth to sons, would you wait until they grew up? Makes sense, right? Like, I can't give you anything. I can't give you another husband, you know? So she really is letting go her past and allowing her past to have the freedom to explore different options. But the story goes on. Would you remain unmarried for them? No, my daughters, it is more bitter for me than for you because the Lord's hand has turned against me. Now, Naomi feels the Lord has turned against her because her husband died and her two sons died because of the famine in that land. And I want you to know the land that they are in is the same land that the wars are going on in this country. There's famine. It's like history is repeating itself. Isn't that interesting? There's wars. They don't want people to marry out of their culture, but they are. So this is why they're coming back home. And at this, they wept aloud again. Then Oprah, did you know Oprah was in the Bible? I did not know that. Boy, that woman gets around. Or she's been around, right? Then Oprah kissed her mother-in-law goodbye. But Ruth clung to her. Look, said Naomi, your sister-in-law is going back to her people and her gods. Go back with her. So she's giving them permission to go back to their mother's house and father's house and start a new life. She wasn't taking them. She wasn't being greedy or needy out of them that they should still take care of her. But Ruth is following her intuition. Listen to what Ruth says. But Ruth replied, Don't urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it so severely, even if death separates you and me. When Naomi realized that Ruth was determined to go with her, she stopped urging her. Ruth was following her inner guidance. She knew she had to be with her mother-in-law. And why was she going with her mother-in-law? She was following her guidance, and she was very adamant about it. Look what she says. I'm going where you're going. I am going to worship your God. Your people are going to be my people. She is going to be a part of that culture because she knows on some level she's moving into a higher realm of consciousness. Everybody in the Bible is a different form of consciousness that we go through. And before we go a little bit further, you know what my problem is about making these sermons? I get too much information. Then I have to ask God on Sunday, okay, God, just sort out what I need to say. But I want to share something with you. Because if not, you'd be here all day like a Baptist church. And I don't think you want that right now. But Naomi, out of the Metaphysical Bible Dictionary, the name Naomi means my sweetness, my pleasantness, delight, my beloved, my delight and beauty. And you can see this in her character, can you not? Charles Fillmore went back and found the root of all the words where they began from to find out what they meant in the metaphysical meaning of them in consciousness. So metaphysically, she represents the soul when it has failed to unite herself with God. She's mad. She's bitter. You know, God took her husband. God took her two sons. And now she's alone and she's moving forward back to town, to Bethlehem. And Ruth, I'll tell you the meaning of Ruth. Ruth means female friend, sympathetic, companion, desirable, delightful, friendship, pleasing, and beautiful. The metaphysical meaning of Ruth, the love of the soul in its natural state, or the love of the natural soul for God and for the things of spirit. Isn't that beautiful? And you can see this in their characters, can you not, as they are being portrayed in this story? So there's a Ruth inside of us. There's a Naomi inside of us. We get mad at God, do we not, when things aren't going our way? Tragedy hits our family. And we're like, you know, come on, God. Do you know that Naomi changed her name from Naomi to Mira? You know why? Because Mira means bitterness. And she was very bitter towards God. Don't we get a little upset with God? I know I do. Why isn't this going the way? And this story is also so intense about trusting the process and that God knows us and is preparing more good for us if we resort back to our personal relationship with God. Ruth really wanted to follow Naomi because of her wisdom and her devotion to God, even though it didn't even shake her when Naomi was so mad at God and so bitter because life did her so wrong. And we get that way. You're shaking our fist. I don't understand God. Okay, maybe it's just me, but that's just my story. I'll stick to it. I'll use me as the example because, you know, anyways. But the setting is back then is about its dark times in Israel and the history when people lived. And you know what they did? In the Old Testament, you will find a lot of stories, and what Ruth and Naomi are doing, they're leaving a country or they're leaving a village that is living in darkness, and they are seeking the light in Bethlehem. They are seeking the light. They're taking a journey where there is going to be new people, a new God, a new understanding. And the mega theme here in this story is the faithfulness of Ruth. She had faith in Naomi when Naomi had no faith in herself or God. Sometimes we need friends like that in our lives, don't we? So they didn't know what God has prepared, right? So they go to this city, and Naomi still has got an attitude with God, all right? So Ruth is so dedicated that she decides that she is going to go to Boaz's field, and that's where all the grain is being grown. And back then, whatever grain was dropped, the poor people were allowed to pick up and take home and use. And Boaz, who was the owner of all this land and all these harvests, he sees Ruth out in the field, and he says to the workers, "Who is this woman?" And they said, "Oh, this is Ruth, who came with Naomi back." And he says to his workers, "Do not molest her. Be good to her, because I've heard of her character." Now, here he is. He says, "I have heard how she has taken care of her mother-in-law. In fact, even leave extra grain for her." Interesting, huh? And Ruth is out there working hard. She's working really hard. She would work extra hours in that. So then Ruth comes home and tells Naomi that she met Boaz. And all of a sudden, Naomi gets a change in attitude. She is delighted because Boaz is a part of their heritage. He's related to them in the line. And tells her what Boaz told his workers. She got so delighted. She was so happy. You know what? She lost her bitterness towards God, because now she saw that God was working for her and not against her. Beautiful, huh? And remember, I have said, God is good all the time, even when we can't see it. This is the meaning of that affirmation, that God is good all the time, even when we cannot see it, because we do not know what God is preparing for us. God knows about our tomorrow. All we know about is our today and what is happening today. So now it comes to thrusting. So that means that Boaz has to go and lay down at night and sleep on the ground so that when it's his turn to do the thrusting of the harvest, that he is there, that he does. Plus two, in case anybody might steal his grains, his bundles. Naomi says to Ruth, "Go clean yourself up. Put your best clothes on. After Boaz has eaten, and he goes and he lays down, you go and you lay on his feet. Lift the sheet and lay on his feet." So Ruth follows Naomi's plan. He wakes up and he says, "Who are you?" She says, "I am your servant Ruth," she said. "Spread the corners of your garment over me, since you are a guardian redeemer of my family." "The Lord bless you, my daughter," he replied. "This kindness is greater than which you showered earlier." He's still seeing more in depth of Ruth's kindness. Now, if somebody else went late on his feet, do you think he'd act that way? So obviously he had a little chemistry working, is what I'd say. You have not run after the younger men, whether rich or poor. And now, my daughter, don't be afraid. I will do for you all you ask. All the people of my town know that you are a woman of noble character. So Ruth was known as noble character. And to me, a noble person is someone who's going to do the next right thing and has a personal relationship with God and is going to ask God, God, what do I need to do? And here, Ruth's mother-in-law's setting her up behind the scenes. And the ending of this story is incredible, to tell you the truth. Although it is true, and I am a guardian redeemer of our family, there is another who is more closely related than I. Stay here for the night, and in the morning, if he wants to do his duty as a guardian redeemer, good, let him redeem you. And that means that there's a next of kin that is before Boaz. So Boaz is a very wise man. And if he's not willing, as surely as the Lord lives, I will do it. Lie here until morning. So she laid at his feet until morning, but got up before anyone could recognize. And he said, no one will know that a woman came to the threshing floor. So I don't have to read all this. I'll paraphrase it. So Boaz goes to the next of kin, and he says to the next of kin, because now Boaz is in love. He's in love with Ruth. He says, I want to buy Ruth's husband's land. And the next of kin said, no, I'm going to keep it. It's mine. And he says to him, well, you know, if you keep her land, you have to marry her. Uh-oh. He says, no, I will sell it to you. I will sell it to you. And here's an interesting fact. You know how they sealed a deal in the biblical times? They gave one of their shoes to the person. And that means that they have a contract now. So the next time you get into a contract deal, offer them a shoe and see what happens, okay? See, church can be fun and joyful. So anyways, he wins Ruth. And Naomi is so excited. You know, Boaz and Ruth, they get married. And then they have a son, Obed. And Naomi is so delighted that she now has a grandson, that she took so much good care of her grandson that people thought it was Naomi's child. Isn't that something? Because she was so, and obviously all the bitterness, and she's praising God for, you know, all this good and these blessings that have come in her life, you know, and Ruth. So you know what ends up happening? Let me tell you. Obed marries and has a son. To make a long story short, it would be like the great-grandson of Naomi or the great-great-grandson of Naomi. I don't know how many greats are in there, but he is King David. King David. And here is the divinity of the line, the alignment of this family, and who do you think is under this family's heritage? Jesus. Naomi couldn't make this stuff up. Ruth couldn't make it up. They could never predict it. All they kept doing was trusting and trusting, trusting in the process, asking God for help, praying for help, asking for... Isn't this a fascinating story? My dogs, they are so educated. And Ruth and Naomi, I kept telling them, guys, can you believe this? They look at me like, okay, Mom, okay. But I can't, you know, I mean, I just got so excited because it's such a short story in the Bible, and it is yet so powerful. The lineage of Jesus comes all the way to the lineage of Jesus, back to Ruth and Naomi. And when they came out of darkness and they went to a new land, a new consciousness, a new people, and things began to fall into place. So my question to you, are we willing to trust the invisible realm? Because what did these women do? They just trusted. They worked. They did the next right thing in their lives. And just kept knowing that God was going to do some good for them. And Ruth has a beautiful life. She's a wealthy woman now. She's well taken care of. Nobody could fix her up with what she got. That was a God thing. We have to wait for the God thing to happen in our lives. And this is the story of Ruth and Naomi. And you know, what are you willing to give up in your life that you're sitting in darkness of? What are you willing to give up, to walk away from, that you know isn't working for you, that you're in the famine stage of your life, that you're starving to death, maybe not physically, but have you ever been starving to death spiritually? I know I have. I know I have. I was in the wilderness for 5 years. It's not a pretty place to be, and I wouldn't want anybody to be there. But I'm sure there's people who've been there even longer times. Some people all their lives, they never get out of the land of wilderness. Or the land of darkness. But here they are. Ruth is an ancestor of King David. Naomi changes her name to Bitter. She finds out that Ruth is getting married. You know how one thing you find out can change your whole attitude? Yeah. If somebody came up to you today and said, hey, I'm going to give you $100,000. Just because I like you and you were kind to me and you were having a bad day before that, don't you think that would change your attitude? I know it would change mine. God is loving us all the time. And sometimes, yeah, it's really scary to just keep putting one foot in front of the other and keep asking God for signs or to show us that we're in the synchronicity of life, and you just start seeing things fall into place. I know all of you have experienced that synchronicity, and that's the story of these two great women in the Bible. They kept following what they felt they were guided to do. I think I'm just going to leave you with that. That's a lot. It's a lot for all of us to think about. Because we have the blessing of our parking lot today. It's potluck, free food. There's no famine at this church. And that. So anyways, I just reflect on it, and if you get a chance, read it. It's only 4 chapters. It's maybe like 10 pages. Well, in big print, it's 10 pages. When I have the pink Bible out, that means it's the big print Bible. So anyways, food for thought. Go and trust your God more. Trust your intuition more and see what God brings to your door. See what God brings to your door. Because you are children of God and you are worthy to receive God's absolute good. And that's all God ever wants to give you, is God's absolute good. And so it is. Amen.
Amen.
I didn't hear you.
Amen.
There we go. That's so much better. You know, it was so funny because when I was driving here this morning, or I started last night, really, I said, oh, God, I got so much material. I don't know really what to say. I don't know how to sort it out, God, you know, what really needs to be said and shared. And so I just, before I went to bed last night, I said, Ruth, Naomi, and Boaz, please guide me and direct me in the presentation of your story. And I feel like it did happen. Thank you. Ask and you shall receive. Now here, this is just FYI. Last night I had a dream. I go into this elevator, I press the number 2, and as soon as the door is closed, all these cicadas came out at me. Isn't that disgusting? Well, you're good. I'm glad I don't have them in my backyard because my dogs would be so sick from eating them. So my friend over here comes in this morning. He tells me about cicadas that he's looking for. I said, my God, you reminded me of my dream of cicadas. And they were all over me, and I was just beside myself. But anyways, I don't know how that relates to today's lesson, but it's just something I just thought I'd share with you. Synchronicity. Oh, it's one of the plagues. That's right. Locusts. But aren't they related? Yeah, great, great, great grandchildren. But anyways, it's time to receive our offering, our tithes and our offerings. And I can't thank you enough for the financial support that you provide for this church, but also your presence. I look forward to seeing all of you every Sunday that I'm here. I really do. In fact, sometimes I even imagine all of you sitting in the pews before I get here on my drive up. You know, I go, I wonder who's going to be here, God. Is so-and-so, so-and-so? So if you ever get a nudge at the last minute to come to church, it's probably me programming you with God to come to church. But anyways, let us affirm our affirmations. 1, I only look to God for my source and supply, for my wealth, health, prosperity, and happiness. I no longer speak words of lack or limitation. I will only speak words of abundance and wholeness. Next, I will let go and let God work in all my affairs. I will keep my wealth circulating wisely. I will give freely and abundantly. My heart is grateful for all that I have and all that I am about to receive. And so it is. Amen. And now I'm going to turn the music department back on. Click, click. There they go. Come on, Susan. Come on, Kevin. Come on, Beth.
We're going to sing River by Bill Stain today. Julie has sung this a couple times, so if you remember the refrain, just sing along with us. If you remember any of the stanzas, do that too. I was born in the path of the winter wind, raised where the mountains are old. Their springtime waters came dancing down. I remember the tales they told. The whistling ways of my younger days too quickly have faded on by. But all of their memories linger on, light in a face.
song ever moving, and winding and free, rolling old river, changing old river, let you and me, river, run down to the sea. I've been to the city and back again, been moved by some things that I've learned. Met a lot of good people and I've called them friends. Felt the change when the seasons turn. I've heard all the songs that the children sing and listened to love's melodies. I felt my own music within me rise like the wind in the autumn trees. River, take me along in your sunshine. Sing me your song ever moving, winding and free. You rolling old river, you changing old river. You and me, river, run down to the sea. Someday when the flowers are blooming still, someday when the grass is still green, my rolling waters will round me bend and flow into the open sea. So here's to the rainbow that followed me here, and here's to the friends that I know. Here's to the song that's within me now. I'll sing it wherever I go. River, take me along in your sunshine. Sing me a song ever moving and winding and free. You rolling old river, you changing old river. Let you and me, river, run down to the sea.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. And I ask the Spirit to bless each and every one of you in the ways that you need to be blessed, because God knows who you are, God knows what you're going through, and God is preparing greatness for you. May you know that in your minds and in your hearts, and we thank you for giving of yourselves in every way, and so it is. Amen. Amen. All right. Announcements, just a few. Cleaning Sunday. Our cleaning person is off Sunday. That means today. It's the fifth Sunday of the month. Looking for volunteers for after fellowship, just to empty out some trash cans and straighten up in the bathrooms. Make sure it just has toilet paper, most important thing in the bathroom, okay? And basically to straighten up the place, contact any board member if you're interested while they're all here. And many hands make light work. Next, we have affirmative prayer. Chaplains and those interested are encouraged to attend. July 10th, read chapters 5 and 6. I'm doing a class on Wednesday night Zoom from 6:30 to 8, and it's Discover Your Divinity. You can get the book online. It's a great handbook in regards to how to create affirmative prayer, how to create them, how to pray them, and the intention. And basically what we're learning in this class is how to pray from the God consciousness and not the human consciousness. And the suggested love offering is 15. And there's a Zoom link that is sent out Monday evening prior to the class on Wednesday. So make sure that Kathy, one of our board members, has your email address if you're just happy to jump on. But this Wednesday night, we don't have class because it is the 4th of July. And a lot of towns provide fireworks on the 3rd instead of the 4th. So there's no class, so it'll be a week from this Wednesday that we'll be doing chapters 5 and 6. And volunteer opportunities, we're still looking for kitchen help just 30 minutes before or 30 minutes after. It's not a lifelong sentence. it's just maybe 1 week a month. We sure would appreciate it. See Diane, she's the kitchen keeper. And we also need greeters about 15 minutes prior to Sunday service to greet people that are coming in the door over here. We have Denise out front, but we do need somebody to do that at least once a month. Either see one of the board members about that, or you can see me. And the 12 Power Salad Festival is going to happen Saturday, July 13th, 11:30 to 2:30 in the lobby, looking for folks to contribute salads. Now, salads aren't hard to make. That I can even do. So, anyways, and make it one of your 12 power colors. This is a fundraiser for the center, and it's $8 a plate. And there will be a sign-up sheet available. Any questions, contact Ida. There she is, right there. She's the lady in charge. And she does this once a year. Transgender is not a decision, but a birthright. And Linda Scott, July 14th, after services, is going to discuss the gender-changing laws and regulations that adversely affect this vulnerable population. A love offering is suggested. She's going to talk about her personal journey. So come educate yourselves, is what I say. And there's going to be a town hall meeting on July 28th, right after services. It'll be in the community room. And you can eat while the board and I talk. Okay, how about that? We're going to give you an update about what we're doing for the center, what we've accomplished, and we also want to hear what you have to say about your church and what you'd like to see more of, less of, anything that's on your mind or your heart. We're here to listen. We want to create an opportunity for you to share your thoughts and your feelings. That's why we do these. And I think there's peace on earth right now. At least it is on our screen. And we're going to pray it. I mean, sing it. When we sing, it's twice spoken. And everybody please stand.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Peace that was meant to be with God as Creator. Family, all are we. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let this be my joyous song, to take each moment, in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
Surrounds us,
the love of God enfolds us,
the power of God protects us, the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well.
Yay, God, yay,
God. Oh, okay.